Let's consider the difference between a job and a profession. A job is simply employment. A job is getting by. A job is what a man does to pay the bills. A profession involves passion. As you will discover, I believe there are two categories of professions: causes and careers. A cause that you support and throw your energy into must elicit some sort of passionate calling within you. A career that fulfills you is one that ignites passion within you to produce something of great value to others. That is the way men feel, a significant way in which men feel valued and valuable, by producing and providing real world value to others. Yes, there are seasons in life where all you might have is a job, a 9-to-5. That's okay. Be productive. But that should only be for a time, as you add new skills and capabilities that will open professional doors for you in the future. I know plumbers who love their profession and are passionate about it. They see it as their gift to their community, and plumbers are generally well paid these days, which makes their skill valuable. I also know men who have graduate degrees in a specific discipline, make very large incomes, who happen to hate their jobs. They have zero passion. You see, the difference between a job and a profession is passion. Now, allow me to share my professional passion pyramid. Now, professional passion pyramid, professional passion grows when a man builds on his self-knowledge. A man truly knows himself, his strengths, his weaknesses, and his interests. And then he applies that foundation to the realms and roles that utilize and capitalize on them. So realms are the specific industries in which he'll flourish, and roles are the specific positions within those industries or companies that he will flourish in. And the ultimate goal, of course, is to serve in a role that maximizes your abilities within a realm, an industry, a company that you are passionate about. That is professional alignment and congruity. And I want to help you get there. And then within that career, the fulfilled professional has the ability to exercise what I call creative influence. He has the freedom and responsibility to get things done that he believes are meaningful to the organization and to the consumer, through his individual efforts and through the efforts of the team maybe he leads. And then in a relentless, ongoing fashion, he applies the force of focus and discipline over the long haul to be his best. This is the long-term perspective so many men lack. This requires accountability to someone you choose to hold you to the standards you set for yourself. And finally, the end goal is generosity. This is the act of giving back the fruits and results of the four layers beneath it. And this is where a man's professional and even personal legacy are forged. What will you be known for today, and how will you be remembered in the future, tomorrow? This is a very important source of meaning in a man's life. Now look, none of these should be static. You will continually grow your self-knowledge, which will grant you a greater understanding of the best realms and roles. And as you do so, you'll continually refine your skills and expertise with focus and intention over the long haul. And this produces an ever-expanding professional capacity. You'll become more valuable and more valued. Now, you know, I talk frequently about the three areas of a man's life: his personal life, his relationships, in his professional life. And there is a constant flow between the three areas of your life. Look, you cannot be compartmentalized like a frozen dinner. Your life is more like a soup or a stew. And as we examine your personal life, I will guide you through a process of discovery and self-preparation, this level that will help open doors for your professional passion. I want to help you stop and really dig it down into who you are and what motivates you, and that might inform your ideal realms and roles in a new way. Now, for most of us, there is a continual intersection between our relational lives and our professional lives. From employers, managers, employees, coworkers, and customers, our professional work requires interactions and relationships with others. Now, these relationships range from short-term and casual to long-term partnerships and deep friendships. And we'll therefore spend a great deal of time addressing what I call the five interpersonal competencies that bring professional success. And we'll have to have a little fun doing so. Now, these are often considered the soft skills of success, as the hard skills, your industry and task-specific capabilities, your hard skills will only get you so far if you don't play well with others. Now, look, I hope this is a helpful paradigm or philosophy of professional striving for greater meaning, my professional passion pyramid. Look, you need a coach or a guide to help you every step of this process. This can be only for a short season or an ongoing fashion. I can help.